Hey guys, here's the needle valve, the fuel needle valve, and I had a problem on the PHBN 16 in that it wasn't fully closing and there was fuel coming past, and the problem was that this isn't the actual needle valve. The one on the PHBN 16, it's on the bike now. It wasn't in the best condition. It was slightly grooved over the time of going up and down into the bush. And I didn't have another one, and I was sick of this. So I decided to see if I could reseat the bush, and you know where the bush is. It's where the valve goes, the needle valve goes, and got to be really careful because it's so delicate. The only way of reseating it that I figured out was to use some metal polish. And a barbecue skewer, a bamboo barbecue skewer, as you can see. It's got a point on it. And by putting in the barbecue skewer, it's obviously quite soft, so it forms itself to the brass perfectly. And with a little bit of paste, metal paste, on the end, then you can pop it in the bush like so, and just clean it up, and it will just polish it. And so it's not, there's going to be no chance of cutting or spoiling the face. All that you're going to do is to actually just slightly, very slightly, modify that edge, and give it a nice surface. It worked. Put the carburettor back on the bike and reassembled, and no more leaking. That was all it needed. Just a little tickle of the bush to allow the needle valve to seat. So if you're in the same situation. Yeah, if you've got a little hand tool like this, and barbecue skewers, bamboo barbecue skewers, I use them all the time for all sorts of things on the bike and everything, and a bit of metal polishing paste. Hey presto, you can regain a fuel-tight carb, and it's great, and it only takes a few minutes. Okay, that's it. Bye for now.